G'day and welcome back to RC Model Reviews. Today I've got a box, well it's a case, and this is from geekbuying.com. Now they sent me an email saying, would you like to review this product? And I've got to say, I turned down more review requests than I accept, because a lot of the products that people want me to review, you can tell right from the get-go that they're just crap. That, you know, no one, you know, to review them would do them a disservice, because you know that they're not going to come out well in a review. Some of the stuff like cheap tatty little drones and things. But the last thing that Geek Buying sent me was that little transmitter, the multi-protocol transmitter, which is still working pretty well. And this time they offered to send me this, and I thought, nah, not interested. But then I looked at the webpage for this product, and it had a really interesting claim. It said, you can use these with your glasses, because this is a box goggle, right? This box goggle. And I'm not a great fan of box goggles for FPV flying. I'm older, and my eyes don't can't in very well, and when you're using box goggles, even though you've got a big lens which adjusts for the focus, you still end up being cross-eyed, because when you're looking at something that's just a few inches in front of your nose and you want to look at the center of the screen, which is where all the action's happening, your eyes have to sort of both point inwards, and it makes you cross-eyed, and it's actually quite tiring and fatiguing on my eyes if I try to fly with box goggles. So I generally, you know, not a fan. And now that we're getting cheaper FPV glasses like the EA Sheen, whatever they were, which aren't, you know, I'm still waiting. Joshua Bardwell said he's sending me his pair. He's sending them off this week or something. So I'll look at those when they come. But with the falling price of goggles and the increasing performance of goggles, I thought, nah, box goggles, nah, you know, not worth reviewing. I already have reviewed the Turnagy Cyclops, or the Hobby King Cyclops, which is really, in my opinion, one of the very best box goggles around, because it lets you wear your glasses. And if you're old like me, being able to wear your glasses means that even if the lens in the goggles themselves isn't powerful enough, you can just wear a pair of reading glasses and then use them quite comfortably. But when I went to the website for this, it said you can wear your glasses with these box goggles. And I thought, woohoo, this is another set, the second set I've seen where you can actually wear your glasses. So it could be really, really worth reviewing. From the point of view, perhaps not of as a set of FPV goggles, but as a set of passenger goggles. Now, I always try and carry a set of passenger goggles with me when I go out flying, especially if I'm flying in public, because members of the public come up and say, what are you doing? And I say, here, have a look. I'll take you for a fly. And generally speaking, it's a great way to not only introduce people to the hobby, but to dispel the fear that people have that you're spying on them with your drone if you're flying a multirotor. So box goggles, I always carry a spare set of goggles, of usually box goggles, in my pack so that I can let people see them, because it's so much easier for average person just to hold a set of box goggles up to their face rather than put on a set of proper video goggles and adjust the IPDs and that sort of crap. And if they wear glasses and you've got a good set of box goggles that allow you to wear glasses, then they can actually see the picture instead of just a blurry mess. So when Geek Buying said, we'll send you these, and I looked on the website and they said, can be used with reading glasses, I thought, woohoo, way to go. Unfortunately, they lied. Well, I don't know that they actually lied, but what they say on the website isn't true. Here's a set of reading glasses, you know, your typical ones you buy at your little dollar shop, and they, you know, your various magnifications. This is a plus four, which I use for really close work. I don't need to wear them with box goggles, but you know, it could be any lens in here. They may be your prescription glasses. And as I say, the Turnagy Cyclops, the best feature of that set of box goggles is you can wear your glasses under them. And if you're dealing with members of the public, a lot of who wear glasses, it means they can actually see what's going on. So I thought, great, I'll review these box goggles, another ones that lets you use glasses. But once I got them, I realized, hey, that ain't gonna work. Look at this. There's no way you can get a pair of glasses on inside these goggles. It's not gonna work. It's not gonna happen, right? So the website is wrong. But it's only wrong a little bit. What do I mean? Well, I'm glad that I got these for review, because they actually have a couple of other features which are really, really cool. And it was, you know, I thought, And let's take a look, for example, one of the things I often carry too is an LCD screen with a DVR, like this, right? There you go, nice LCD screen, anti-glare coating, built-in DVR, SD card. Now these are really good. I've reviewed this one, and I like it, because it's got, doesn't have dip switches for changing channels, so you can go up and down easily through the channels. Doesn't have a scan, unfortunately, so it is a pretty old one. But it's a SkyZone one, I think, from memory. Don't know. But you know, it's got Velcro on the back, because if you want to use it, you've got to put a battery on the back. It doesn't have a built-in battery. I do have another one with a built-in battery, but it's just the devil's own job to change channels because it has dip switches. Who on earth thought of that? But there you go, so I carry that. But this is pretty easily damaged in your backpack. And as I having to have a separate battery and a lead and things in it, oh, you know, it's a bit how you're going. It only has one antenna, but I sometimes carry that. Well, when I saw this, one of the things that stood out with this particular unit is it is a set of box goggles, and I have tried them, and that lens is nice and strong, so I don't need to use glasses under there anyway, although some people may need to. But look, it's got a tripod mount on the bottom here. What's going on there? And I'll show you what's going on there. You can also use it as an LCD display. This bit here pops off. Look at this. If I can do it. Look, and there you've got an LCD. And here you've got the box goggly bit. See the big lens, big magnification. Woo! So if you're going to go out in public, you can take this as a backup set of box goggles. But you can also, if someone wants to see what's going on, you can just give them this bit. Or you can put this on your tripod. And there you go. It's built-in sunscreen, so you're not having to worry too much about the glare and reflection of the sun. You can just angle it like this, and there you go. All the even in the studio here, the glare is gone because the lights are not shining on the screen. Of course, you can. It will look bad if you shine it the wrong way. And I thought, well, that's pretty damn cool. But hey, wait, there's more. It's got a DVR in it. And I know the Cyclops doesn't have a DVR. This has got a DVR. Woohoo! And how much would you pay for this? Well, they're quite reasonably priced. They're about $75, I think, US dollars, which is pretty good considering you're getting a set of box goggles, an LCD display, which can be used standalone. It has a built-in 2000 milliampere hour battery, so I don't know, that's probably good for at least an hour or so, maybe longer. It has a DVR, it has scanning function, and it has antenna diversity. Ooh, yeah, you know what I think of antenna diversity. And I've used this, I've done some recording with it, and honestly, I compared it to the SkyZone goggles that I recently repaired there, and I'll show you some clips comparing. I took the same flight, filmed with my, or recorded with my SkyZone goggles, and recorded with this using the supplied patch antenna and cloverleaf antenna. And here's an example of the comparative footage you get from each. Now, one thing I noticed is that the quality of recording isn't quite as high. It's a bit more blocky, pixely. It's kind of like got a bit of a mesh in it. It may not show up on the edited video as such, but you're getting a $75 piece of kit. It's not a $350 piece of kit, so you don't expect the same results as you'd get from a set of SkyZones. And when the signal starts getting weak, well, you really notice the difference between antenna diversity and receiver diversity. The SkyZones cope far more effectively with dropouts and things because it just switches to another antenna, another receiver, I should say. These things, it's trying to make its mind up which antenna to use, and it doesn't do a very good job. I may do some more filming later with just a dummy load on one of the antenna inputs and just using one antenna. I have a feeling it will perform better with one antenna than with two. But it works. Basically, it works. If you're using this as a spectator goggle, they're going to be happy. They've never seen anything better, so it's the best they've ever seen. And for the price, it's really good. And if you don't want to take the whole damn thing in your backpack to show people, you're going to just take this bit. It's small, it's light, it's self-contained. Hey, and you can even record your sessions. Now, you can even use this as a bit of a backup if you want to, because one of the things that we all fear most is if you're flying FPV and something happens to your goggles and they go black. And somewhere out there is your plane or your quad. By the time you establish take your goggles off and try and find it in the sky, it can go a bit of a distance and it can be hard to get back due to orientation. Have this sitting on the ground or on a tripod, and it's your backup. It's your backup thing. So if your goggles fail, hey, you can just fly it back using the LCD. Brilliant. Nice. And of course, people come along, they can look at the LCD, they can see where you're flying and so forth. It's just a really good piece. For $75, it's cheap insurance. So yeah, you could do the same thing with one of these, but as I say, the LCD screen doesn't have a built-in battery. You can't use it as a set of goggles if you want to. So yeah, there's a place for this. There's a place for this. I would not, if I was just getting into FPV, I probably wouldn't choose this as my first set of FPV goggles, because as a set of FPV goggles, they're a bit lacking. You cannot wear glasses under them. And when you put it together, let's put it together so you can see what it all looks like here. If I can remember how to put it together. I mean, it goes together quite nicely. No problems there. But if you look at it here, it doesn't sit on your head very well. I won't film my head in it, but if you look at it, unlike most other things, there's no weight on the back. And there's a huge amount of weight right up the end here with the battery and the receivers and the LCD and all the other gubbins. So it's really nose heavy. In fact, we'll get the scales that don't show the blood and we'll see just how much it weighs. Here we go. All loaded up and ready to roll. If I can get it so it's all going to sit on there nicely. Total weight is a pretty hefty 414 grams. Now that's pretty heavy, especially when most of that weight is actually hanging off the end of this cantilevered off the great distance here. So it tends to fall down a bit on your face. And also this place where your nose goes is way big. I've got a pretty big hooter and there's still a lot of light leaks in through here. So it feels like it's always trying to fall off your face. Not a comfortable wear, but for spectators, who cares if they're comfortable? As long as they can see the picture, it's all that really matters. So I'd say as a set of FPV goggles or box goggles, there is better on the market. You probably won't find much cheaper, although the Cyclops is pretty well priced. I'd go for the Cyclops instead of these if you're looking to use them yourself as your first set of FPV box goggles. The antenna diversity, yeah, it's just not that good, but it's satisfactory, it's adequate. But really where this shines is as a set of passenger goggles. I would buy one of these for passenger goggles because it gives me it's a dual purpose thing, it's double function. If it's not being used as passenger goggles, it's a DVR. It's another LCD screen as backup for my flying or to hand around to people who want to see what it looks like from the plane or from the quad. Brilliant. So yeah, for $75, it's not bad value, I've got to say. It's worth $75, but it's not a set of fat sharks. It's not a Cyclops. But when you add all the little bits and pieces up, it's good value for money. So yeah, if you want some passenger goggles, then you could do worse than buying this. There you go. Now, there's a link to the product in the description of this video. It's not an affiliate link. I don't make a bean from it. If this was really crap, I'd tell you. But as I say, you choose for yourself. Look at the video footage. It's not the best DVR in the world, but it's a DVR. And it's not the best set of box goggles in the world, but they work. So there you go. Pay your money, take your choices. If you've got questions or comments, anything you'd really want to see about this, I will give this to a couple of the local club flyers here to try out and see what they think. But I have a feeling they'll probably agree with me that wouldn't be their first choice as a set of box goggles. And I might actually, next time I'm out in public, take this out and I'll film people looking through this, members of the public, and just see how well they respond to this as a set of spectator goggles. I think they'll be quite impressed. There you go. Thank you for watching. In the meantime, bye for now.